Okay, now I'm going to try to use my 4 minutes wisely and see if I am able to communicate to you what is my areas of research interest. So my work in a sense, this is better. my work is focused on, as you see, the early education of children who are growing up in bilingual, and I would say bilingual, multilingual context. And I just want to clarify that for those of you in the field of education who are not familiar with this, my research is not necessarily in bilingual education for young children. That is one of the settings or one of the approaches that are the context in which these children grow. So I'm looking more broadly into the different contexts and experiences that young children who may not have access to bilingual education and care are going through or experiencing. So, and that makes sense, and that takes me, you know, of course, there are changing demographics. This work, I began this work in the early 2000s, is a long time ago, at the University of North Carolina, Chapel Hill, where I graduated and began my research career in the United States. So at that time, there was, in North Carolina, there was a big influx of the Latino community and the state. And we had early educators that didn't really know what to do with children that they couldn't communicate because the children and families didn't speak English and the educators didn't speak Spanish. So that was kind of the context. I'm going to move quickly. I could talk about this a lot, but definitely, you know, there were therefore inequities, not only in access, because families didn't know where to find early care for their kids, and the quality, because the programs were not prepared to serve this child population. And then another part of the context is the increased accountability requirements for early childhood programs. You know, quality rating and improvement systems around the country have developed, but all of that was happening at a time in which, you know, there was an invisibility in those standards about the needs of these children, young children who were bilingual. And definitely, as I mentioned, the workforce was not prepared to serve them. So in that context, I developed, and my colleagues and I at North Carolina, we developed an intervention project. So we began an intervention research program that we call Nuestros Niños. So I'm going to, you know, we began with conducting a national survey to really identify the needs at the state level of early childhood care and education programs that were serving this population, how much they knew about them, what the policies and status was. And then we began working in developing this professional development intervention, as I said, to address the limited preparation of the early educators to work in around and work with the children and their families. So that led us to, after we conducted this national survey, we led us to design a multi-state randomized controlled trial to evaluate the efficacy of our intervention program. So, and that including what we faced was the reality that measures that were already existing measures to evaluate the quality of care in early childhood, care and education in early childhood, of course, did not include practices that were specifically designed to address the needs of this population. So we had to start from square zero, just also developing our own measures to assess quality in language acquisition. And I have 1 minute, and that's what figures are for, right? In 1 minute, you can just see, this is a proposed conceptual framework that my colleagues and I have put together and actually recently published. I think it reflects our view of how work interdisciplinary interdisciplinary work is needed to address the needs of this population of bilingual children, especially adding the whole experience also of having a disability when they have them. So I will just, I think I will just stop there. International work in 30 seconds. In addition to my work in the United States, I am working in both Peru and Mexico and examining the needs of children who are experiencing the transnational experience of going back and forth. And this is with Jalisco and also in Peru, looking at intercultural bilingual education in preschool and elementary. I will stop there. That's a lot of work. Thank you very much for your attention.